I'm Christine Ballard, and thanks for signing up to my workshop. This little video is my intro to you. I hope it gets you excited by the week and helps take some of the stress out of getting the equipment. The week is titled Easy Ways to Expressive Art and Abstraction. We will be taking a journey with some of the great masters to understand how and why they painted in a certain way. Through this, you will create your own artworks and learn some techniques that will help your artworks be more expressive. So I thought now that we might go through the equipment. For drawing, you'll need some charcoal, some pencils, lead pencils, 2B I use, but any Bs are good, an eraser and a pencil sharpener, and also a sketch pad, A3 size. For painting, I'd like you to get 4 sheets of watercolour paper. I choose Fabriano Artistico, but it doesn't really matter as long as you have 300 GSM so the paper won't buckle. I'd also like you to get 4 small canvases, 12 by 16, kinda, sorta, that'll be fine. These are the size here. Now, if you don't want to get stretched canvases, that's okay too. You can choose to get a Frederick's canvas pad, which is quite useful, and we can cut that out and tape it to board. I've also asked you to get 2 large canvases. I've specified 90 by 90. They don't have to be 90 by 90 if you can't get them in the car. Just square would be good, but any will be fine. Plus, I'd like you to get another large canvas. For one day, we want to be really expressive, so something a bit bigger than 90 would be good. Again, do what you can. I understand we're all traveling. I've also supplied a list of paint colours. I suggest Matisse Derwent acrylics, but any artist quality paints will be fine. Your neutrals, black, white, Payne's Grey, burnt sienna, yellow oxide, and raw umber. For your brights, you just need primary colours and a warm and cool in each of those. So, phthalo blue, ultramarine blue, crimson, scarlet, cool yellow, and a warm deep yellow. You can also get some gel medium, and this will help keep the paint wet and give it a little bit more flow. Include a small jar of impasto, which is thick, and it will give texture to your paint. You want a range of brushes. I've listed 2 to 12, but any you've got are fine. I like a long flat with a square edge, but that's totally up to you as to what you would like to use. You'll also need a palette. I suggest 1 of 2. Disposable palettes are nice and easy. They come in a pad and you can just throw the sheet away when you're finished. If you want to make your paints last a little bit longer, then a wet palette might be the trick. You can buy wet palettes, but they tend to be quite expensive. They come with a small tray, and when you open the lid that seals, then they have the palette paper and a sponge. And you fill this with water and it keeps your paints really dry. But you don't need to buy one. You can make one by just getting a shallow plastic dish with a lid and go to the shop and get some kitchen sponge and cut it to fit, and then get some baking paper and place it over the top. Bring the roll with you because you'll throw that out after a while once it's used up. And there is your wet palette. It'll keep the paints nice and wet, and you can use them over a couple of days. Other things you'll need are some paper towels, a water bucket, a spray bottle, an apron, a camera or a phone, and an easel. Now, if you don't have an easel, you can hire an easel for $7 a day from Artscene. Please just let them know beforehand so they can have it ready for you when you get up there. And that's it. So I'm really looking forward to meeting all of you, and I'm sure we're going to have lots of expressive fun. I'll see you in Bathurst.